As a director of two festivals in Austria, in Graz, which is the second city of Austria, it's a city about 280,000 people, so it's not a very big city compared to Cairo. But Graz is a city of a very long tradition of culture and music, and it's a quite an old city. It's a beautiful old town, but it's also a young city for students. There is a lot of students. Out of these 280,000 people, there are 50,000 students in the city. So we have four universities there. It's also 50,000 people of migration. So from other places in Austria, other places in Europe, but also other places from other countries in the world came to the city to live there. And so this is a quite interesting also for artists to work with these topics about migration, about changes in the cities, and about how we live together in this multicultural world. I have examples in my lecture today of artists who worked in the early 60s in Austria, and they went out to the street, and they were the authorities were not able to deal with this, and they were asked for very simple things to come with them, because it's not normal to go out on the street and perform there. You have to imagine Austria in the late 50s and in the early 60s. We call this time in the first 10-15 years, it was kind of the post-fascistic time in Austria, and there were several artists who kind of cried this out, and it was really important, because it was not changing a lot. It was really a depressed society, and the authorities still were not sure where to move, and so they started to deal with these symbols of this time and to try to open the minds of the people to a different other time. And so the authorities were very much afraid about them, because they wanted to change this, because this time of fascism and then post-fascism, the people just changed their dresses, a lot of them, and not their minds, their brains. And so there was this time when these artists really forced to change things. In my experience, I always had the feeling that the artists we work with, and they always have their nose in front. They have a good feeling for the future, and they have to be honest. They for themselves, and they work together, and they are watched very well what they do. In Europe, in the moment, we have a lot of questions and topics we have to deal with. We should invite artists to the center of the development of the society, to be critical, to talk to them, and to make their work very important in the development of our societies. I think the most important thing is to bring arts to places and people who are not to down level the steps, you know, to bring it really to the people, because, and also to people who just don't have any access to any art. And it's very important, and it's a tool also to make them talk to each other, to think about how they live and how they want to live, and to give them voice. This is what I think is important, to do it outside, and to create new spaces for a more artistic life for all the community, and to give a sense to the life and to the way the people live together.